Alrighty, what is going on? Welcome back to YouTube. Today is Saturday, the 15th of June, and we're officially 13 weeks out. We're in a powerhouse today, we're in for legs. This video is going to be a bit of a weekend training sessions. Got legs today, got pull back here again tomorrow. So, you know, just going to pop some raw clips together, take you through some training. I'll talk a little bit throughout, depending on what energy levels I like. Try and add some sort of value. Either way, we'll show you what our training is looking like at 13 weeks out. Alright, for anyone that's followed me, you know the drill. Top up delt work for double rest pause at the start of the legs. Rest for 30, then go again. To calves, of course. Get some warm ups in. Yep. I don't need to show the rest of the warm ups. I'll go one plate, two plate, three plate, and then into a working set. Okay, first working set. We've got 75 kilos loaded. Trying to get a one count in the stretch, one count in the contraction. So now we load up a little bit more with 90 kilos for what I call my heavier set. I've been doing calves at the start of my leg session for the better part of 2.5 years since I stepped off stage in December 2021 last. And one thing I've found super helpful is doing sort of that higher rep, still heavy, set first, then into a heavier set, still in both those sets a bit more control, in both the stretch and the contracted, then going into a still heavy but, you know, higher rep set with a little bit less control in the change of direction, because your calves are already pumped up that you can kind of just keep the reps moving. So obviously I'll do this and then I'll do a third set whereby I'm just, you know, I wouldn't say balanced in, but with less control than these first two sets. So you can see that it probably was a little bit more challenging to get short than some of those, but equally, the loading that I can get on the, in the stretch is very, very good. Anyway, that's where now I'll go a bit quicker. I'll pull back to 70 kilos, but I won't bother filming that one. Alrighty, you won't know that there's a slight time delay between the calves and the adductor, but someone came over and started chatting. Good bloke, but probably should have nipped that in the bud a little bit sooner. Okay, got double breast balls with the stack. Feel me in my warm-ups or talk anything through my warm-ups there, because I had a nice jump in on the hack squat and do some warm-ups with me. Taught him a few things, you know, in terms of foot position and knee path, tempo of reps. Did pretty well. I wish I had a probably film something like that, because it's actually quite informative. But regardless, just did my top set, 4.5 for 8, that last rep. What a grinder. But fuck me. Like, I did 7 continuous and then a big pause before that final rep. Glad I got it, match reps. However, obviously noting in the logbook that last time it was, as in on Monday, it was 8. Relatively, I say easy, but you know, I didn't struggle like the last rep there. And probably had another rep in the tank on Monday. So, you know, I take that, I say match reps with a grain of salt. Hence why writing in your logbook, you know, a bit of why that's the case is so important. But anyway, I've got 4 plates loaded. Let's do it back off. So the aim here will be trying to keep these reps as continuous as possible and not come all the way at the top, aka not lock out. Song choice for this back off. We've got Run This Town with Jay-Z, Rihanna. What a tune. Set on that. So for anyone that's followed my previous leg sessions in the past, I was doing the banded hip press, but yeah, that became quite fatiguing and a bit of a doozy to set up and all that. So squat press, reverted back to it. It's quite a safe movement and all that. So did 8 plates plus a 5, so 8.25 match reps. Got 10 pretty solid reps on that one. It's more or less just to get under the load, get good range control, and you know, the rest will take care of itself in terms of quad stimulation and all of that. So that was a very solid set. I'll take that. And as I said, just the one set, I think probably maybe a month or two ago on that second quad compound of this session, we pulled that down to just the one set. But anyway, let's crack on. Okay, onto the glute drive. We've got six biggies per side loaded. With four plates, but quicker in tempo. All right, one set of line ham curl. Battery is almost dead, but we'll see how we go. Movement. This is the first set on the leg extension. Locked and loaded, gym pin, seatbelt. One thing I've been doing on the leg extensions of late has been like consciously leaning back at the hips. That way, you know, when I then contract, it's lengthening my quads as much as possible, as opposed to when I'm crunched over, you're not able to lengthen them as much. Get more of a stretch, contraction. I find it feels really good, you know, you get that full quad right up to the hip. Just done a bit of posing here. Unfortunately, the sun is beaming down in this corner, so the lighting's not very great. I feel like my quads are pretty pumped and hams, but maybe a little bit flatter compared to Monday. Either way, that's gonna round out today's session, but it's not gonna round out the video because I'm gonna also film tomorrow's pull session. So stay tuned, you'll see me back in the gym here for tomorrow's pull session. Catch us then. Alrighty, just like that. We are back in at Powerhouse this morning for pull. It's just gone about 8 in the a.m. Pull session on the card, so we've got the hyper extensions first up, T-bar rows, all of that malarkey. But you'll see that in due course. You can probably hear in my voice a little bit of a sore throat. I know Olivia had a bit of a sore throat earlier in the week. Maybe I have a little bit of that now. It's often worse first thing in the morning, but obviously I've had, you know, necessary fluids, etc. But it seems to get better throughout the day, so hopefully another few good nights of sleep and we should be all G. Anyway, without further ado, let's get warmed up on the hypers and yeah, get warm. The posterior chain builder. As you can see, I've got it set up such that I've got a couple of plates to elevate the hyperextension machine. That way you get extra range at the bottom, and that's purely why. And it's good angle, and I find what setup works for me. You know, this is my entire posterior chain builder movement, or it's one of my favorite ones, and it's less taxing compared to like, you know, a deadlift, an RDL, a stiff leg, that kind of thing, which is, you know, taxing, of course. This one still is challenging, but gets a fair whack out of your posterior chain. Anyway, I'm going to warm up with just body weight to start. Make sure I'm getting a really good stretch in the hamstrings. Squeezing the glutes at the top. And obviously my hamstrings are already a little bit, I wouldn't say sore, but you know, I can feel them from yesterday's leg session, which you would have seen as well. Which I actually think is not a bad thing in terms of, you know, they're already a little bit pumped. Yes. Okay. I'm going to start loading some weight. Probably don't need to show you any of those warm-ups. And I'll catch you for the top set. All right, we've warmed up with one plate, not the bar, then one plate, then two plate, then three plate. I say plate, but they're tens, obviously for greater range. I'm going to pop some chalk on now. Not that my grip's slipping, but will this warm my hands up? Because it's very cold and grip is a big thing in this one. My hands are still a little bit chilly. It's like 5 degrees, so it's a little bit cool in here and haven't really, I say, gotten warm. I'm warm, but you know what I mean. So anyway, let's lock in for this top set with four plates, or 80 kilos plus the bar, if you will. Okay, back off time. Gonna be quicker in tempo. Probably not as controlled. That's because my hams, glutes, erectors, they're all pretty pumped already. Got the bar plus 60 kilos loaded. So let's give this a whirl. You know, I've been chatting to a guy in the gym, and you know, I message him and chat on, you know, Instagram a bit with him. Good guy. Anyway, he competed in season A in the IFBB. Anyway, he keeps messaging me when I put up my check-in photos on Instagram. He's like, bro, you could put on a tan and get up on stage. And you know, it's all good and well to say that, but you know, the reality is I'm not stage lean. You know, as AJ put it in one of my latest check-ins, was at the minute I'm lean, and people might say, oh, how many weeks until you're stepping on stage, thinking that it might be a couple of weeks out. But in 3 or 4 weeks I'm going to be lean, and then it's like, oh shit, you're competing this weekend. It's like, nah, we've got more to come off. And then in another 3 or 4 weeks after that, so a couple months time, it's like, oh shit, like, do you need to go to the fucking hospital? You're that unwell. So that's what we're going for. We're going for world-class conditioning. And I won't be satisfied with anything less than that. With that being said, we're on the T-bar rope. We've got 3.5 plates loaded on the Watson T-bar. My main aim here is just to get my elbows back towards my midline, and not wanting to do, you know, a significant amount of lengthened partials, otherwise it just defeats the purpose of the movement. So I'm happy to do one or two of those at the end of the set, but ideally don't want it from rep number one, so aka hence why there's not 4 or 5 plates on here. Whew. get the sniffles out. Yep, that had a call set. That was one of those last two or three that I just couldn't get fully short. Back off here with three plates. It is much easier if you have an assistance on the lift off because of the way it's to one side. You've sort of almost got to unrack it and then sort of readjust yourself. But you can't really be asked talking to anyone, so three, two, one. Yep. I think the Nautilus pull down is probably one of the most butchered movements I'm around. I think I talked a bit about it in a YouTube video ages ago, a couple months back. But anywho, the aim of this and why I advocate for a lot of lat-based back work to be done unilaterally for a few reasons, but like I find specifically on this, like you're kind of wanting to lean to one side, and if you're doing dual arm bilateral, you then can't, because obviously you're doing both hands at the same time. But anyway, some of the things I'm thinking about here is specifically is locking in with my opposite arm, and it's a nice little grip here, and I'm not forcefully wanting to come all the way up, because if I roll my shoulder forward like that, which a lot of people do because you think that you're getting more stretch in your lat, you're actually not. All I can feel it here is in my shoulder, my traps, upper back, and it's actually not stretching the lat any further. So anyway, if I keep my lat slightly depressed back, then shoulder depressed back, also that slight lean back from the torso, and don't need to come all the way back down here because you're actually not stretching your lat any further. So an ideal range that I'm wanting here is, you know, pretty much stretching my arm as far as I can without rolling my shoulder forward and driving down towards my elbow, sorry, my elbow down towards my hip. And almost less range at the bottom is better. And like all I'm feeling is my lat down at the bottom there. And I'm keeping boxed off here in that I'm not, you know, driving like that all the way back, because that's not actually giving you any more range. So, hopefully that helps some people in some form of informative content. Anyway, I'm gonna warm up with, so that was two plates, I'll do three plates, and then the top set with four plates. Okay, let's put that into practice with four plates. Oh yeah. Wouldn't say I fully locked out that seventh, but it was not too bad. I didn't, you know, roll my shoulder back or, you know, compromise execution just to get that rep, trying to keep it within its active range. But anyway, do the right arm and then do a back off. All right, second back off. I've done the left arm. We've got 65. Loaded a bit quicker in terms of tempo compared to the top set. Mm. The Flex Fitness chest supported rope. Just got two bickies on here. It's very heavy. And I actually just do the same weight on both sets. Not too dissimilar to the Nautilus pull down in that, you know, I'm wanting to effectively lean towards the arm I'm doing. Doing these unilaterally, still lat focused. Obviously instead of Nautilus pull down, which is a vertical pull, I've got a horizontal pull here. So obviously we'll start the left arm and such that I'll lock myself in. That's a wrap for the back component. Now, let's hit some biceps. All right, onto some cable curls. Doing them bilaterally because it feels good and saves some time. That is going to wrap up the session and the video for that matter. So obviously a little bit of posing there. The lighting isn't quite as good and whatnot on the camera just due to the lighting coming in from the side, but that's all good. You'll see what I'm looking like 13 weeks out. Got that session done in, you know, decent timing, so it's only 9:50 now. Got to get home, eat, check-ins, probably edit up some of this video, and going to the footy this afternoon at Marvel. So that's it for this video. If you liked the video, please like and please subscribe. I think we're at 381 as of filming this. So if we get to 400, that would be pretty cool. Anyway, enjoy. Catch you in the next one.